Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Jan Sewing Solutions. Now then, I try and steer away from children's making children's clothing, but no matter how hard I try, I cannot seem to keep away for sewing for my little baby. There is always beauty in sewing for children. They are the best customers ever, and I keep emphasizing that, and I can't help but keep coming back to sewing for Inaya. Now today we're going to do sort of like a slightly wrapped over trailed dress in net, and the net that I'm using is from these scarves. Okay, what I've basically done is folded this into a cone, and I'm going to cut the front and the back. The back is going to be obviously trailed and it's going to be longer. The front is going to be shorter. It's going to be slightly overlapped at the front, so it's going to have like, we're going to put like double buttons, and then we're going to underlay it with some more net, which is going to be a little bit more fancy. So what we're trying to do is cut out cutting too many pieces, and we're going to cut this. It's going to have a lot of flare, which is what we basically want. So we want it nice and long, quite long at the back. This is 2.5 yards of net, and I tell you, this net you can actually pick up for literally peanuts. It's almost like buying it for free. So this is 43 inches, and what we're going to do is we're not going to leave that 42 inches, but we're going to, on the sides, we're going to take it to about 36. And then this, I'm just going to sort of like curve out, and I'm going to take a little bit away from the bottom as well, because it's just going to be too long. So this, let's take a gamble. You know what, even if I was to go wrong, how much wrong could I do? Because it's only a cheap net, it's literally costing me absolutely nothing. So once I open this up, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come back. That's the original one, and I want it less at the front. So this way we've got sort of a like a 6 inch less at the front, slightly longer, but it's like a cutting into a like a circle, but it's not the full round circle. So I'm going to put this back. What we can tell is that the back is a lot longer and the front is shorter. Now here I'm gonna be taking out a sort of waist area, because I'm gonna be adding this is gonna be overlapped, so this is about 10 inches in total, which is, that should be more than adequate. If you need to lengthen the waist, you can actually go slightly down, which we may need to. It's an idea not to cut this, and then I'm gonna, because what am I doing? No, I'm gonna cut them the same. So what we have is, now that's the waist, and that's the kind of fold that we're getting. And the way this is going to come is, these pieces are sort of going to be like overlapped. And I'm gonna pipe these, and I'm going to seam them prior to attaching this all the way around. So that basically is the gear of the dress. Now this is quite long, because I've still got to add a border, and I've got to add, this is way too long. So what I'm going to do is probably need this as my end result, the end finishing. This is how long I want it all finished. So in order to make this shorter, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a couple of inches all the way around the side.
Thank you.
beautiful peach color. My princess is going to look like a princess in this. It means wasting. This is just like a piece now that's just wasted. If you need to add like a frill or something on anything, that'll do for that. Now that's the skirt part, and it's all in one, so we're not going to get any seaming or anything. And this is going to go on top of another net that we're going to cut. Now I've got some left here, and what I want to do is I've got to make her sleeves, and I also want to make I'm not going to use this for the top part, but I do want to make her a scarf. So I'm going to take a portion of this off. I want to make her a nice long scarf to go with this. I'm going to join the pieces to make the scarf. And this part, I'm going to make nice long sleeves, which are going to be... I'm going to cut them slightly at an angle. This is one mistake that I always make, that make her sleeves too tight. I want them nice and long. I'm going to trim it off with some velvet at the front. And make them too tight. Put them at a slight angle. She's growing, so I need to make her clothes just a little bit bigger then. That's the sleeves. Perhaps I'll add this as a frill to the scarf. And then this I'm going to use as lining. So this I'm going to cut on a straight, but with we want is a similar type of a cut. So the back is going to be longer, so we want this to be longer at the back. Thank you. Now I've been cutting silently, and there's a couple of things that I'm going to point out here. When you cut this type of net that I'm using to go underneath, let me tell you that this has a less of a lifeline than the one that I'm using on top. So basically what I'm doing is using this as my lining, because it shows a beautiful reflection in the upper net, but the upper net has a far more life. So if this doesn't actually have a contact with the outside influence elements, then the life of that net will be far more than the top one, than the bottom one. So the top one, it has obviously is far more lasting. So my advice would be that if you get this type of a net, then use it, but use it as a lining rather than using it on top, because if you cover this with an overlay fabric, then you will get far more life out of the whole garment. So inshallah, that's what we're doing. What you saw me cut out earlier was the two portions, which was the skirt. I'm going to be making this in two parts. So the full length one, this is the one without the cut, is the one to the back, and then I've got the front one, which has two panels because of shortage of fabric. Obviously, if you don't want to, if you want to waste the extra fabric, then you can actually do away with this and without the seam, and can do it on the you know, but because it's going to have an overlay anyway, it's not actually going to be visible. So what we're going to have is this is going to be the bottom portion, and then this is going to be overlaid with this. Now this is the skirt part of the portions all cut out. What we want is the bodice. I'm going to be using a different fabric for the bodice. So my bodice is going to be made out of this. This is some leftovers that I had in one of the suits that I did earlier on, and I put this lace on. Now I've already pre-pressed it. Again, I'm going to line this, but and then it's just, I'm going to cut the bottom portion of this will be trimmed off in this. The front of the sleeves I'm going to trim off in the in the velvet, and that's going to be the trimming all around the side. And then what we're going to do is find some buttons in maroon, and button that blue in maroon, and